I need good music, fresh, new, good music all the time. I hunt every day, I dig every day, but yesterday I bought this Hello Stranger by Jennifer Lara. Shabab, shabab, my baby. Shabab, shabab, hello stranger. Ooh, it seems that... My name is Lucas Cortese. Welcome at Cap Calcini Company. It's a record distribution that after the years became an online record store. When CDs appeared, of course, the vinyl business got a big dent. And when the Jamaican sounds went CDs, then the foreigners went CD as well. Mm-hmm. And that's when everything collapsed, you know, domino effect. Most people in the business died. The vast majority of my former colleagues, competitors, and also clients have closed. Mm-hmm. What is selling now, what is really in demand, is from 70s come back down. Mm-hmm. 70s to 63, ska, mm-hmm. rocksteady, early reggae. For the real hard to find collectibles, the prices can be really surprising. Mm-hmm. You know, Endless Memory or such crazy records, or Free Farm or Near Wrangling. A beautiful picture hanging on the wall. That's all. I've had situations where people's current profession is to break stones in the countryside. And when they realize that their record is being sold for $200 a piece, they don't feel good about it, because they probably went to the studio to record that record. It was self-produced, they had to do it for themselves. And one of the reasons why it's so rare and expensive now is because it was manufactured and sold in small amounts. Basically, they never made money from it. There are two type of record collectors. The ones that are attracted by the aura of the old item. The typography of the 60s, the whole sentimental aspect of it, etc. Then you have a next set of more audiophile-oriented people that realize that those records, especially the ones that were mastered in an analog way, that were recorded, mastered, and reproduced in an analog fashion, have a higher definition. Jamaicans are very musical people, and I guess it comes from the slavery days, where people could sing. It was one way to endure the hardships of slavery. It was also a way to communicate between them. So I think it has an ancestral place or an historic place, mm-hmm. in Jamaican culture. Mm-hmm. Jamaica is a poor country, so it also helps them to forget about the hardships of daily life, not only from the cane field days, but also from nowadays ghettos.